Hey, Algebra 2, today we're going to talk about inverse relations and functions. Well, what is an inverse? Inverse, basically, if I were to give you a set of points, say 1, 2, and negative 4, 5, the inverse would be to switch these coordinates. Okay? Well, what if you're not given coordinates? What if you're given a function? Well, what we're going to have to do is just a couple easy steps to find the inverse of this function. The first thing you always want to do to find an inverse of a function is switch x and y. Don't change any numbers, don't change any exponents, don't change anything. Only switch the letters. That's your first step, is just change the position of the letters. That's the first step, switch x and y. Notice the 3 halves didn't change, the minus 6 didn't move, it's just the x and y. After that, we get y by itself. Those are the two big things you need to know about finding the inverse, is switch x and y, get y by itself. So we switched x and y. Now to get y by itself, we're going to add 6 to both sides. So you get x plus 6 is equal to 3 halves y. So now we need to get the fraction out of there. And again, the way we get rid of a fraction that's being multiplied by a variable is multiply by the reciprocal. So we're going to multiply this side by 2/3. So these cancel out. We're left with y is equal to 2/3 times x plus 6. Now, if I want to distribute this to, I'm sorry, the 2/3. If we distribute the 2/3, we'd end up with y is equal to 2/3 x plus, that's 12 divided by 3 is 4. So this would be the inverse of our original function. Now it also asks, is the inverse a function? Well, what makes something as a function is if it passes the vertical line test. If you were to graph this, this is an equation of a line, you notice that it looks something like this. If you were to graph this, up 4 is your intercept, your slope is up 2 over 3. So if the vertical line test would pass here. So yes, this is a function. Yes, it's a function. And again, the example of something that would not be a function, the graph of something that would not be a function, is if I were to give you a sideways parabola. Because notice, if I did the vertical line test, it would cross here and here. So therefore, this would not be a function. Okay? So again, the big things about finding the inverse is number one, switch x and y. Don't change any exponents, numbers, coefficients, nothing. Just switch the letters. And then from there, get y by itself and take the necessary steps to do that. All right. Now, the next type of problem you're going to see is a graph. Here we have a graph, and you're asked to find the inverse. Again, find the inverse. And is the inverse a function? Okay, well, I have here, this is a function, passes a vertical line test. What I want to do if I'm given a graph is actually think about the coordinates. So the coordinate for this point is negative 3 down negative 2. This one is back 1 up 1, so negative 1, 1. And lastly, this coordinate is over 2 up 1. Over 2 up 1. Now, in order to find the inverse of a graph, all you're going to have to do is switch the coordinates. So this becomes negative 2, negative 3. This one becomes 1, negative 1. And this one becomes 1, 2. All I did was flip the order of the x and y. Just like we did with the last problem, we switch x and y. So with a graph, you switch x and y. So now we're going to plot these new points. This is negative 2, negative 3. So back 2, down 3. Okay. This one is over 1, down 1. 1, negative 1. And lastly, this is 1, 2, over 1, up 2. Now, if I were to connect the dots here, this is what I would get. So this is the inverse right here. It also says, is the inverse a function? Well, if you're ever given a graph in which any part of it is vertical, this would not be a function because this does not pass a vertical line test. Right here, it's touching my pen at an infinite amount of points. So therefore, for this problem, it's not a function. The inverse is not a function. Okay? Now, also what you can tell, a way to tell if you've done the graph correctly, is, sorry about that. If you've done the graph correctly, then if you were to draw the equation y equals x, so basically it's at a 45 degree angle, if I were to draw a dotted line that looks like this, notice it would be symmetrical on both sides of this line right here, y equals x. So every function or every graph, when you graph the inverse, if you do it correctly, you're going to end up here. Will it be symmetrical to y is equal to x? So that's just another way to tell if you've got it right or not. Okay? Again, plot the coordinates, write out what the coordinates are for the original, flip the x and y, and then graph those and connect the dots to find the inverse. Okay? All right, let's go on to our next problem. All right, here. Here we have, write the slope-intercept form of the equation that best describes g of negative 1. Now, this right here, that doesn't actually mean the exponent negative 1. This is notation for inverse. So when you see something like this, that's actually saying the inverse of g. So we know that g, it says, is 3x minus 5y equals 15. And we're trying to find the inverse of g. Okay? So again, this is just notation. This is not an exponent saying g to the negative 1. This is inverse. Okay? All right. Well, the way we find that is we switch the variables. Again, 3y minus 5x equals 15. Okay? Now, that was step one, switch x and y. The second one is to get y by itself. So we're going to move it to 5x. Now, again, this has x, this doesn't, so you can't combine those. Those are not like terms. So we have 3y equals 5x plus 15. I like to put x first because notice it says slope-intercept form. Remember, slope-intercept form looks like this, y equals mx plus b. And lastly, we get the y by itself by dividing by 3. Y is equal to 5/3 x plus 5. Okay? So that's what our inverse is. Y is equal to 5/3 x plus 5. This would be our answer. Okay? And again, slope-intercept form, y equals mx plus b. Switch x and y, get y by itself. Okay? So that is how we find the inverse. Okay, let's move on. Function q is described by y equals 2x minus 6. So we have q, which is y equals 2x minus 6. Sorry, 2x squared minus 6. Write the equation describing the inverse of q, solving for y. Are q and the inverse of q, a pair of inverse functions. So what this is asking is, if this is a function to begin with, this is a parabola, we've done these. The inverse, is that a function also? If they're both functions, then they're a pair of inverse functions. So again, the first step is to switch x and y, but leave the exponents even. So this is just x equals 2y squared minus 6. Now we get y by itself. Add 6, you get x plus 6 is equal to 2y squared. Get the 2 out of there by dividing. Now I'm just going to go ahead and move the y squared on the other side. Y squared is equal to x plus 6 over 2. And lastly, the way we get rid of a square is to root it. And remember, whenever you take a square root of a variable on in an equation, the other side is going to be positive negative x plus 6 over 2. Now, if you were to graph this, so here's our inverse, y is equal to positive negative x plus 6 over 2. if you were to graph this actually ends up a sideways parabola. Okay? A sideways parabola actually would be actually yeah, it would be around right here. So, the way you can tell is if you were to plug in a 1 or if you plug in any number, if you were to plug in 0 for x. If you plug in 0 for x, you get 0 plus 6 over 2 is positive root 3 and negative root 3 for your y value. So when x is 0, you have positive root 3 and a negative root 3. But you can't have 2 points lining up one above the other if it's going to be a function. So in this case, if you have a sideways parabola, we know that this is not a function. Okay? So, an easy way to tell automatically if something's going to be a function or not is if everything's to the first degree, which is a line, if you take a look at these, a line, we know the inverse is going to be a line as well. Okay? This is a line, this is a line, every line that's not vertical is going to be a function. Now, if this is a parabola to begin with, if I were to get rid of these, whoop, sorry about that. So if I were to draw a parabola, and now I draw my y is equal to x, in order for this to be symmetrical, this would have to be a parabola going sideways. And so, which again does not pass the vertical line test. So, if you start off with a parabola, x squared, to begin with, you know its inverse will not be a function. Okay? So again, this is how we deal with inverse relations and functions. So switch x and y, get y by itself. Plain and simple. Switch x and y, get y by itself. All right. Well, good luck with that.